Yoink.
It's a vlog.
Hi, I'm Simon, welcome to CG Films. It's a vlog. Yeah, I'll be taking 15 minutes of your sweet, valuable time like I normally do, but there's loads to discuss about that I need to talk about, and plus, I haven't been making a video for 5 days because I was too busy playing on Halo Reach, which is one of the games I've been playing on the Xbox 360, the most played Xbox 360 game that I ever played, because I've been playing for like 4 days and stuff like that. But yeah, it's just that the midnight launch and the unboxing of this got like 3,000 views, and I like to say thank you guys for viewing, and also like to thank new people that have subscribed lately. I like to thank all you guys for subscribing, all that, for viewing on my unboxing video and plus the midnight launch for this game. And it's a fantastic game. I've been playing a lot, and most of my friends have been playing a lot. Most of my friends have just been playing Modern Warfare 2. What have you been doing lately? You should be playing this game for the Xbox 360. It's a fantastic must-have for the Xbox 360. It's the most anticipated Xbox 360 exclusive game that I know I'm ranting fanboyish and stuff like that, but it's just a brilliant game, and I've been playing loads of my usual friends like Defy, Space Godzilla, Surgeman X, and Turtlebird, Corrupt, Soap, and all the types of people that I've been playing. And I also want a quick mention that basically I've been playing with this person, Bing, that I'll put an annotation to, but basically I've been playing with this person that I don't usually keep in contact with him, but to be honest, I'm a fan of his videos, and plus he's a fan of my videos, and we've been like, it's quite funny because he went into my Xbox Live party and we've been like discussing about Halo Reach, because we've been discussing about Halo Reach and the Forge mode, because we've been like playing a few games on Firefight, and then we went straight into Forge, and we've been like playing about with Forge and stuff, and we had a nice chat and stuff like that. And plus he made a Gates of Hell that was very clever ingenuity. But I had fun with him, and he's a really cool guy on YouTube, and he does some really good reviews. So yeah, I'm an invitation to and bit of a shout out. So I'd like to say thanks for playing with me, because I don't usually keep in contact with him much, but like I said before, he's a fan of my videos and I'm a fan of his videos. But yeah, Halo Reach, really good game. Now, I just want to quickly mention about the limited edition, because one consumer, which is Citizen Wolf, sorry that I'm bragging, but basically, I'm not dissing you, mate, or anything like that, it's just most people have been having issues with the whole, the diary of who created the Spartans, and there is a particular thing that has been found by Citizen Wolf, and I don't know if you guys realise this, but I'm not saying I haven't read this yet, but one of my friends, Cam, who is a Halo fan, would read it, but I know that I'm mostly dyslexic, just want to quickly say, I know I'm mostly dyslexic, but I just wanted to get this for collective value, and I know most of my friends that come round would like maybe to read it, like Cam, for example, because he likes reading and stuff like that. But there is like a little tur, as you can see there, that I bookmarked. There is a little tur there, and I do not, it's meant to be like that, because I know it's meant to be like that, because I've been chatting to most people that have the limited edition, and basically there has been like meant to be, there is a tur on that page, and I think it's meant to be like that, because Citizen Wolf, not dissing you like I said before, but he's been complaining like, maybe because it's a printer error, damn you printer errors and stuff like that. But I think it's meant to be like that, and I'm just not sure why that some people have been like, you know, having issues with that. But I just want to quickly say about the limited edition, in case any of you guys have the legendary or the limited editions, didn't notice that. But don't panic, I think it's meant to be like that. I just want to quickly mention about that sort of issue and all that. If not, blame Microsoft or Bungie or whatever, the printer company and stuff like that. But yeah, I want to quickly mention something, which is basically, and now I'm not much of a gamer, not really a hardcore gamer, those people are Modern Warfare and stuff like that. I know that I diss Modern Warfare games in general, because the way that they're too pro, if I like to say, and stuff like that. But a major thing that has been happening one of them nights that I've been playing on Halo Reach, and I did one of them things where I did one of them COD moments where basically I don't do like much deaths and plus loads of kills and yada yada. I could go on 15 minutes if I wanted to about Modern Warfare 2 and stuff like that. But the major thing is that I did one of them things that I could never done before in my entire gaming thing, which is multiplayer wise, since I'm a big multiplayer fan. But basically, I didn't die in Halo Reach matchmaking, and I was if I like to say, camping, and basically I've been camping with a sniper rifle on the Forge map, which is a remake of the Halo 1 map, and basically I've been playing on that map, and basically I was just like picking off kills and snipering people, and I didn't have no deaths whatsoever. I just want to mention that, and I'm really proud of myself as a gamer to pull off that, and I never think I will accomplish that sort of achievable or achievement. I should have achievable for that, not having a death ratio and all that. But I just want to mention that I might particularly do a commentary video on that. I know that I diss commentary videos on YouTube, Modern Warfare 2-wise, but it's just a slight different change, and plus I actually did something good on the game for once, and I really want to show that. So I would do some commentary video for you guys. In case you would like to see that, I'll post a comment on the doobly-doo and let me know if you want to see that video. I would personally would like to show you that video, but I'm not so sure if most of my fans would appreciate that. I know most people like my commentary because I'm quite a funny commentary guy sometimes, but it's just the gameplay that most people dislike, because I did like a COD 4 commentary and it was a bit rubbish because loads of people in there complain like, "Steven, you're not that pro enough, I like the commentary anyways," and stuff like that, because people liked the commentary and people didn't like me dying a lot. So yeah, anyways, so I will particularly do a video on that, which I will do some point later on next week. I just need to record it on my Dazzle and stuff like that. I saved the match recording. I just really want to show you that, guys. I don't know if you guys are interested. Just let me know in the comments on the doobly-doo. Anyways, I need to talk about news-related stuff now, since I've been too busy talking about Halo Reach and whatnot, over-topicking like I normally do. But basically, there's been some gaming updates that have been happening, and there is the Tokyo Game Show. Tokyo Game Show! Woohoo! I don't know why I said that. But basically, there is a game event that just happened, which is the Tokyo Game Show event that happens in Japan, or Tokyo, or whatever, that happens every year. I always keep on forgetting loads and loads of gaming conferences, but that's one of those things that happens every year, which is the Tokyo Game Show. And they announced loads of, not the same loads, but some cool things. But basically, there is going to be another Dead Rising 2 case. Now, I know there's like Case Zero, and I know loads of people have been complaining like, it's a paid demo, and stuff like that. But there is going to be another case, which is a case called Case West. We actually link up between 1 and 2 for some reason. Basically, you get to meet Frank West, which is an awesome thing. Now, I'm not so sure if it's going to be an XBLA, or it's going to be a DLC, or if it's going to be 400 Microsoft points, or a paid demo, as people would say. But I'm looking forward to it. I'm a big fan of Dead Rising. I played Dead Rising 2 Case Zero, as you may have saw in my gameplay. I really enjoyed it. And I will be picking up Dead Rising 2. Just want to quickly mention that I'll be picking up this Friday. That'll be taking some money out of my savings, and I'll be getting that game. So that'll be looking forward to Dead Rising 2 Case West. Another thing that's announced was Ninja Gaiden 3. I know most of my friends, Space and Surge, I don't know if Surge is a fan of Ninja Gaiden, but mostly people that are fans of Ninja Gaiden, whatever it's called, or get them mixed up. But basically, there's a new Ninja Gaiden 6. Lol. I'm not with it today. But basically, yeah, there's a new Ninja Gaiden 3. And also, Capcom has done a thing where they basically rebooted the entire Devil May Cry. I was going to say Dead Rising. And Devil May Cry series. Now, I did play one Devil May Cry game, which was Devil May Cry 4, but for some reason they decided to reboot the series and change the character appearance quite differently. I saw the trailers, but okay, I just don't know why they rebooted the series. Maybe because Capcom are like that, I don't know why. Sorry, bit of refreshment there. But yeah, I just want to, those are the only things I know from the Tokyo Game Show. I haven't been paying attention to gaming news recently because I've been too busy playing on, you know, Halo Reach and all that. But another thing I would like to mention is Pokemon Black and White is now released in Japan. Japanese people always get, you know, and stuff like that. But yeah, and also for those guys that are hackers and also that would like to try out Pokemon Black and White, you can download the ROM that is now available in some illegal sites and whatever these days and all that. And I also want to quickly mention, in case you do own a DSi XL, do not update it, because if you update it, then you can't use your R4s and other types of random ROM emulator card things. So I just want to quickly then mention that for those people that have DSi XLs. Well, I updated mine because I never use an R4, but my sister does. But my sister does because my first stepdad is actually a pirate. Yeah, and I only mentioned this a couple of times anyways. And so, yeah, I just want to quickly mention about that and, yeah, about the ROM. Another thing I would like to mention about patches and stuff like that, the PlayStation Move has been released since Friday 17th. I will be particularly getting that, but I've got other things on my mind at the moment. But I will pick up a Wii, I was going to say Wii, a PlayStation Move. And I would like to try out some things, like, say, for example, these two particular games. Now, these two particular games will be game patches. The patch for an iPad has been released, and it's 2GB download in case you already own the original version of iPad. But, yeah, it's a 2GB download for the patch for being able to use this on your Move. And plus the PlayStation Move patch update for Heavy Rain will be coming out at September 22nd for those people that have the original copy. And it's good to have the original copy, so basically I can patch update them. But the problem is, though, that I only have a 40GB PS3, though. So I might need, at some point, I need to really upgrade at some point. Because it's ridiculous how that these patches take up most of your memory if you have only original ones. But they will be releasing Move editions. This is why they're releasing Move editions for those people like me that only have limited amount of memory and stuff like that. So yeah, I just want to mention that for those that are PS3 owners. But there are loads of demos on PlayStation Network for you guys to try in case you own the PlayStation Move and stuff. So that'll be for those guys that are enjoying the whole PlayStation Move. It's quite funny because I went into town today to pick up a particular something, and one of the hot chicks in my local game station were just demonstrating the PlayStation Move. I thought, hey there. Sorry, I'm a bit of a perv sometimes. So, right, anyways, enough about that. I want to mention something about iPods. Now, this here, right here, that I have in my collar is actually the iPod Shuffle. Now, the reason why I picked one of these babies up, because as you may know, that I will be getting my iPod 4G soon, even though this is a 2G model. And like I said before, it's meant to be for my sister that I'll be giving to soon. But it's just that, basically, they didn't came out in retail stores in my local area. So my mum, sweetly my mum, because my mum is so nice, she ordered my iPod and Touch 4G on apple.com or .co.uk, whatever. But basically, she ordered it and it will be arriving any point soon, between Monday or Tuesday or whatever. But I'm looking forward to the iPod Touch 4G. I will do an unboxing. It's just the reason why I picked up one of these beauties is because I just don't know why, I just like it, because I saw it in Cash Converters and I spent £15 on this, which cost me £15 in Cash Converters. I don't know why, it's just a little handy thing to have, I just like it. I don't know why, because most of my friends said I'm a money waster, and I'm wasted a hell of a lot of money on this, and I will be getting the most popular, you know, MP3 player of all time. I don't know why, but another thing, the reason why I picked this up is because what will happen if I lose battery on my iPod Touch and I need like a backup for music and stuff like that? Which this is why I picked up one of these. And plus another thing, the reason why I picked up one of these, so I can store music onto it and not physical data like videos or pictures. But it's just that my Xbox though doesn't do like iPod Touches, so that's another reason to have one of these. I don't know why, I just like the colour on it. It's nice and green. It's just really cool and handy to have. And plus, I'm starting to like iPods a bit more, and plus starting to be a bit of an Apple person. Not saying I will get an Apple iMac, but what can you do? So anyways, that is my update for you guys. Do check out my videos I'll be doing sooner or later. Anyways, hope you've been all day. See you from CD Films.